Yo, YouTube, what is going on? It's your boy, dude named Chris, here bringing you a brand new video. I know it has been a while. Sorry. Work has been crazy, but hopefully more and more videos will be coming out soon. Right now, we got a new pickup, and I'm excited to get these. Let's open the box. Story about these, I completely forgot on release day. Well, didn't completely forget. I was out working, so I didn't really have my phone. Always wanted them, not gonna lie. That's a cool little touch, a little bit of bubble wrap. There's the box, if you know what it is. Always wanted them. The prices on them was a little bit too steep for me. There we go, fireworks. The price was a little too steep, so I kept waiting and waiting and waiting for a price to come that was more of my, what I thought I could pay for them. I paid $300 for these. Sale, light bone and white. Retail was $160, so basically played double retail. I had free shipping though, so that's basically one of the reasons why I pulled the trigger. There you go, Nike React Element 87 in a size 12, 13.5 in women's. Have not even seen these in person yet. I know they're going to be releasing in a bunch of colorways, but this is the OG colorway. Cool stock. This one's stock X. Should I bitch at them? Again, a stock X, you get your comeback. You came back to the future. Thank you for stock X regular. A few things to remember. Your stock X card, stock X receipt. Without further ado, here are the shoes. And holy cow, they are super light. You've probably seen them a million times, but there they are. The sale bone. And these are fire. Sorry if I'm a little dirty. I just got off work. There's your close-ups. Is your translucent midsole, which I like a lot. This material is so thin. Ooh. The React has got the squish. It's got some squish to it. I'm gonna do an on-foot review probably in a week or so after I wear these more to give you guys an honest opinion and basically compare these to Ultra Boost. You got your Stock X authentic tag right there. Your cork insole, which I think is a super dope touch with your big old swoosh on it that says Nike React. Again, a lot of people like the shoe is the deconstructionist. It does remind a lot of people of an Off-White, how you have your stitching on the outside there and there. And basically how you can see all the other stitching. Actually, right here, which is super dope, I did not know. Some suede. For basically strength, you got suede right here as well. But yeah, man, I know you've probably seen them a million times. Just basically getting to show that I got my pair. Wait for the review, the on foot review, and the honest review of them about a week or two. But yeah, man, tell me what you guys think. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up button. And if you want to keep it with me, the channel, hit the subscribe button down below. But until next time, y'all, this is your boy, dude named Chris. Have a good one. Okay, so I'm back with part two. Sorry. I cut recording and instantly went and tried on the React 87s, right? Nike React Element 87. I gotta hear, that's a mouthful, to be honest. And I tried them on, as you can see, by the right shoe. Because, to be 100% honest with you, I was super nervous on how these fit. I have a super wide foot, and with runners, I usually don't go true to size. I have to go 12.5. And even at that, sometimes they're not wide enough for my foot. So I did put these on, or put the right shoe on at least, and I walked around. And here's my honest review about them. These are amazing. It's an experience to put these on, to be honest with you. The fit, 100% true to size. Like I said, I have a super wide foot, and these fit me perfectly. And I couldn't be even happier. No size up, no size down with these. 100% true to size. These are 100% true to size. The React, it's different than Boost. It is extremely comfortable as far as that fact of Boost. But when you're walking, when you're doing this, and you hit this point of your walk, it feels like it boosts you. Which is, I know Boost, I know, but... So you're walking, you're front of the foot, and then it feels like it goes like this. like that. Like, it's crazy. They are extremely comfortable. As I've seen on Hess Kicks, he wore them for a month, and the midsole holds up very well. It has, like, this super rubber right here guarding the React, which is right here in the middle. But as far as fit, it's 100% true to size. Extremely comfortable. This is a great shoe, and I can see 100% why people are saying it is in run for shoe of the year. Definitely a shoe that I'm going to beat up a little bit more, and I want to wear it more and more and see how it holds up. But first initial thoughts, the fit is perfect. The comfortability is perfect. This shoe is honestly perfect, man. I can't wait to wear the different socks to make the shoe look completely different. But yeah, man, just thought I would bring that back to you guys. And another thing that I didn't really notice is I thought it was a little swoosh. I don't know if my camera will pick up. It's a big-ass swoosh throughout the whole shoe on the cork. But yeah, man, it's a little weird to get used to just because of how thin everything is. But I love it. The comfortability of it is great. This shoe is just... If you want the best colorway, in my opinion, right now, this is the best colorway. This shoe, I believe, I've heard a lot of people, it'll be a GR. I don't know how much of a GR, but Nike will more than likely be pumping out a bunch of these shoes in this model. That's just what Nike does, man, to make their money. But this is the OG colorway. I know they have the black, which is technically OG, but this is the OG that everyone wants. Super happy to have this. Probably will honestly get more Nike Reacts in the future. Different colorways. Like, the black pair would be nice to have as well. Maybe. Just maybe. But yeah, man, I just wanted to hop back on this camera and give you guys the full review of this shoe. If you think you must have it, cop it, man. This shoe is great. If not, just wait for other colorways, man. But I definitely suggest that for that $160 price point, you check it out. It's different than Boost. I know Boost is $180 to $200, so it is a little bit cheaper, but it's definitely a contender, boys. Definitely a contender. But there you go, man. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Please hit that thumbs up if you did. Again, like, comment, subscribe down below. But until next time, y'all, this has been your boy, dude named Chris. Have a good one. For real this time. I like diamonds, I like stunning, I like shining.